until you know it, baby. Tell me your troubles and doubts, giving me everything inside and out of love, strange, surreal and dark. Think of the tender things that we were working on. Slow change may pull us apart. Wanna let get in your heart, baby. Don't you forget about me. Stand above me, look my way, never love me. Rain keeps falling, rain keeps falling.
starts falling, I'm going to be a pilot.
No.
Okay, what are you going to be? I'm going to be a fireman. Pat Keenan, I'm still trying to get through high school. I'm stuck. I'm going to go to college.
What are you going to do in college?
Study printing estimating and printing management.
Okay.
I think I see it. I'm going to rule the world. I marry a rich girl.
Hi.
Give me your name and what you're gonna do when you grow up.
My name is Christy and I'm gonna go to OCC and I don't know what I'm gonna do yet. That's it.
What?
I want to be a nurse. No, a nurse. My name is Jay. I'm going to San Diego State.
What's your major going to be?
Partying.
I hope you're not lying to
me. What am I saying? Tina. Whatever.
Whatever.
I'm terrified I'm going to be a commercial artist. Ben Karen, I don't know who this is, yo. I'm going to school.
Darren Vickers, Live Meyer Sim.
No, block me,
dude. Whoa, my name is Joe. I'm going to MIT, become a nuclear physics, and open a chain of sausage stores.
I'm going to be a lawyer.
Okay, who do you admire the most?
Who I admire the most? My mom.
Craig Williams, I want to be, a bum or a cyclist. I don't know. I'll probably live with my parents until I'm about 45, and then I'll move out the house, maybe.
Okay, what's your name? What do you want to be when you grow up?
I'm a fireman.
Wow.
All right.
I want to be a forest ranger or a dancer.
A dancer.
What you want to be when you grow up?
My name is Karen Gillock, and I want to be a model and a radio broadcaster.
Who do you admire the most?
Here at the school?
Anywhere.
People who can get their life together and do what they really want to do.
Okay.
No, I don't know. My name is Cindy. I don't know. Maybe a preschool teacher.
Okay. Your name?
Chris Sarver.
What are you going to do when you grow up, Chris?
I want to be a modeling agent.
Okay. Okay, ladies, turn around.
Hi.
Just in mind. Give me your name and what you want to do when you grow up.
An actress. My name is Camille.
I don't know.
Yeah. Being a makeup artist. Being a, I don't know, airline stewardess.
Yeah.
A cosmetologist.
What's your name?
Veronica.
What's your name?
My name is Keisha. I want to be an accountant.
All right.
What?
What do you want to be in your job?
A cop.
Okay.
What is the question?
What
am I going to be?
Yeah.
I don't know. What do you mean, what am I going to be?
What do
I want to be? A businesswoman.
Doing what?
Doing what? Mom, what do I want to be? I want to be just like Mom. what I want to be? A business administrator.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. What do you want to be when you grow up?
Russell Rodriguez, and I want to be a lawyer.
Hi, I'm sorry, Maya. I want to be Rick. I want to be a TV evangelist.
Okay, what's your name?
Serious, Nicole.
Okay, Nicole. How old are you?
Okay.
What's your name?
Cynthia. A movie star.
How about you?
I don't know. Maybe a lawyer.
Okay.
Maybe, I don't know.
It doesn't bite.
What?
It
Just advice.
What do you want?
What are you going to be when you grow up?
I'm going to be a cosmetologist. All of us. What? My name's Tina, and I want to be the same thing she is. What? All of us, a cosmetologist. My name's Christine, and if I don't marry a millionaire, then I hope to become a hair designer in Beverly Hills.
President of the United States.
That's all?
That's it.
Who do you admire the most?
Jimmy Carter.
Anything, but I don't ever want to grow up.
Never, ever.
What am I going to be when I grow up? I'm going to be a famous neurosurgeon. Operate only on animals.
Only on animals.
Okay, I want to be, I'm serious, a journalist, so really bad. I'm going to write for like People Magazine or something.
Oh, okay.
Okay?
All right.
When I grow up, I don't know. I'm going to go to the Navy after school, or after I come out of Navy, I don't know.
Okay.
TV evangelist.
Singer.
Yeah, a rock singer, yeah.
Can I wear my glasses? All right. What am I supposed to answer?
What's your name?
My name is Pat Dolan.
And what are you going to do when you grow up, Pat?
I'm gonna be a fireman.
All right.
I am. A decorator.
Who do you admire the most?
What's that?
Who do you admire the most?
Me. And him.
Oh, there he is. You got me already. All right, Mr. Cool, what's your name? What are you going to do?
My name is Ty Young, and I'm going to seek pleasures throughout my whole life.
Hey, okay,
what's your name? What are you going to do?
My name's Damien. I don't know. I'm grown. This is as grown up as I get.
Makeup artist.
Okay.
Farm club and go on to play baseball with. My dream team is the Cincinnati Reds, but I really don't know, you know.
Oh, I'm going to go to Colorado State, play some football, smash some heads. You know? Smash some heads. Be a ballerina.
After 4 more years of education and 4 more years of football, hopefully we'll become a successful businessman.
Okay. What do you want to do when you grow up?
When I grow up? I'm undecided right now, but... Well, when I grow up, I'm going to be a professional baseball player. If not, I'll go into business for myself.
What dreams are made of.
Get him in.
Yeah. I want to be in the foreclosure business.
All right, if you could be anybody in the world, who would you be?
Thank you. Like psychology, that particular major in college. The Russians have been ahead of us for a long time. I'm going to try something now with a young lady out here. A young lady is sitting there with the long blonde hair. So may I ask you a question? Come on. Do you want to leave? Oh, come on. Let's get a long blonde. It won't hurt. Come on. Hi there. How are you? You want to ask your students? Can you have here? Oh, Maroon. Come on up and do a picture. This is a nice part of the show, part of the show. Get to meet your name?
Corey.
Corey, hi, I'm Earl. Corey, have you ever tried any mind control that controlling me, your boyfriend by just mind power alone? You have? Has it worked?
No.
No. Well, you'll find after you get married that the wife does have a definite control of her husband, which is what we call mind control. But it's time to spare me just a moment with that. It's so warm down here, it's so hot.
Yeah.
The face is leaking like a leaf. Okay. I have here an article from the Los Angeles Times that says ESP teacher works to prevent overbelievers from exploitation. So I'll take a sign to the picture of the air back with the blindfold on, which I'm going to try to put on later on if I'm not perspiring too much. I left one column dangling here at the edge, and I have a pair of scissors here. Okay? But I call your attention, hanging beneath that picture there, of whoever that gentleman is, an envelope that will stay in your sight throughout the whole experiment. In a moment, I'm going to take the scissors, so that I'm going to go up and down this column left from this article in the LA Times. When you want me to, you all you have to say is stop. And I'm going to cut to the line that you say stop at. Alright? So you have total control over this. You can say stop whenever you want. I will stop there and cut at that line. Alright? Your free choice. We'll try some type of mind control. Look at the center of my forehead, now. Hold it down. Look at the center of my forehead. Hold that little bit up and down. And when you want me to, you tell me stop. Right there, they're going to cut. I don't even want to touch the paper. You can see I twisted. Fix up the column that you cut to. Okay. Now, would you look at the line you have me stop at? Stop. You stopped me at a particular line. What was it?
Writer and
left from the newspaper. Would you now take the envelope from below the picture? Now, ladies and gentlemen, I tried to type a mind control with her. There are probably 80 or 90 lines in that particular column. She could have stopped me at the top, at the bottom. She stopped me at writer and lecture on the subject. Open the envelope up. Before I came down from my room this evening to perform for you, I wrote something down on a piece of paper, put it in the envelope, and then it was placed here on the demonstration blackboard. Boy, those nails are a dangerous weapon. Beautiful fingernails. Open it up, make sure there's only one piece of paper. Ladies and gentlemen, if this works, we will have used mind control. Would you please? What does it say on the piece of paper?
Right,
I'm not sure. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Thank you very much. Oh. All right, hey, very good audience. We got some good vibes over here. Do we have any brother, a sister, or sister-sister, or brother-brother combinations? I'm serious. Just we're going to try something because sometimes between siblings.
Ray!
Where's your brother?
Ray!
Is he here?
Ray!
Can I ask you to come up? For brothers, sisters, sometimes husband and wife combination, if it's a family or something. Could you stand on this side, please? And your brother is coming up, he's got, oh boy, he's got it right. I wish I had a tank up on my back. Be nice and cool up here. Your name? David, that's right. Very good, David. Thank you. And your name? Craig.
I've seen double or... Paternal twins. That seems to be in Stephen Clary, this way also, by the way. Magician that was here? She's also here. Okay. Now, I've got a question. Have at any time in your life, has something maybe happened to one of you and the other one sensed that something was wrong or something was going on? Have you ever had that happen? We'll see what happens. I'm going to try an experiment just with the two of them, and we'll see if we can get something going mentally and get some type of bond going between the two of them, okay? Not bonded, bond. I have here a large deck of playing cards. I do not use ESP cards. There are only five symbols in it instead of ESP cards repeated again and again. But I like to use large deck of cards for this reason. There are 52 different cards in the deck, so the possibilities, of course, are quite high. Now, when I was here earlier, I tried this with the chef in the kitchen. I said, and I asked him to cut the deck of cards. And actually what happened is he did cut the deck of cards. As you can see here. Now I'm going to start with you, if I may please. I want you to notice the cards, expand them out here, are all different. The faces are all different. Backs are all the same. I like a chorus line. Now what I'm going to do is flip these over. Judge about all I want you to do is to run your finger up and down along the top of the card and stop at one of them, put your finger on it. Just back and forth on the top. When you get a feeling, stop on a card. Now, you've selected a card, here you go. Take a look at that card. Don't show it to anyone, just you look at it. Okay. Now what I'd like you to do, sir, start thinking of the card. Picture in your mind's eye, whatever this is, whatever the value is, and whatever the face of the card is. And I'll show you the same thing here. Spread these cards out. I have the other half of deck right here. A half of deck, I guess. You can't get a deck into half, you can only tell it's a half. So I'm going to do the same thing here. See, the faces are all different, the backs are the same. You move your finger back and forth across the card, and when you have a feeling, want a feeling, get a feeling to stop, stop and touch the card. That one is right there. Now, you have just gotten a feeling, you stopped at that particular card, you were thinking of a card. The card that you selected, or the half of the card. Let's see if something's happening psychically between these two gentlemen tonight. So if you hold the cards together out here in front of the audience, you see who had a match. I don't know what's going to happen. But let's see how close you came to picking the card that he had. What? Clear space? The one you have? The match. Formulate the numbers in your mind until you settle in on one.
What is the
Okay. Here we go. All right. We'll try that in a moment, by the way. Okay, I'm receiving a thought pattern. Stay with the number, it's very Freudian, but stay with it if you would, sir. Young lady there? Uncross your hands if you would. That's right. Okay, thank you. Thank you, stay with that number. That wasn't the number, by the way. Young lady here? Good, stay with it. And the young lady over there, please. Look straight at me. Think of the number if you would. Several of you around her are thinking of numbers, please. If you're doing that around her, do not. Just let the one person think of it. Okay, I've received something. I'm going to try something here. Down here to the front of the stage by the lectern. I want to have you do something for me.
You start off, would you write your number down on line number one? You're bigger than I am, I'm just nervous to thank you. Now, may I ask, is there an instructor here that might teach math? Is there a math teacher here? No math teacher? Is there a math major? Somebody's very good at mathematics here. Does that one, sir? Is this Tim McLean? Let's give a round of applause. You have to take the board smoothly. Would you now total those numbers up, add them up so that you come up with a total down here. So ladies and gentlemen, let's recap what just happened here a few moments ago. I asked four different people to stand up, four different people thought of a number. Okay? Well, you wrote the numbers down. Gentleman here is coming up with a total. He's now double checking. Okay, what's the number? 1699. 1699. Thank you. Let's give him a round of applause. Let's get back to the seat. Now, ladies and gentlemen, out of all the mathematical combinations possible, if I come within 5 or 10 or 20, in either direction, I feel I'm doing pretty good. But you came up with 1699. The impression that I received before the people even stepped up here, the thought pattern that I got, had me come up with a total of 1698. One away. Thank you. Thank you very much. Listen, I'm never always correct. Sometimes, listen, I cannot, and I'm not. It just doesn't work at all. This is a good audience. You're having fun. I'm enjoying being up here performing for you. I pick up some good vibes from you. And also, I pick up the fact that there are going to be some other good things happening for you as you continue on in your life. This is only the first day of the tomorrow, so I wish you the best of luck, and I need 2 more assistants to help on today. Okay. Subject. Can I ask this young lady here? The same note. Come on up and help if you would, please. So let's give her a round of applause. Gentleman back there sitting next to a gentleman in a tie. Yeah, I think he has his fenders on. What's your name? Pardon? Gene, how are you? Happy graduation. Wish you the best of luck in your name. Hi, Steve Romo. How are you, Steve? Good. The reason why I brought the two of you up here, I'm going to try something that's very warm, and I don't know how well this is going to work, but I'm going to show you a demonstration now of what some people call X-ray vision. Now, let us say, what is that? If I only want to
wondering what this is all about. How many of you who have heard of maybe a person who was deaf that had a tremendous sense of touch and smell and hearing? Seems to be when God takes away one of the senses, the remaining senses become heightened. Sometimes the person who can't hear has acute sight, or a person who's blind has a sense of hearing that's acute. I'm going to show you an experiment on what happens when you remove your sight for a period. Now, I've been doing this for some 40 years, 40 some odd years, starting in Hawaii where I was born. My mother played a little game with me and blindfolded me as a child. I bumped into a lot of coconut trees, which explains probably why I'm doing what I'm doing for a living right now. But I'm going to try something, and you two, because I can't have you all up here helping me, you two are going to be doing watchdogs for the people in the audience, all right? To do this experiment, we're going to use the blackboard. We're going to use these green boards, you're right. You're going to use these eight pieces of tape that are sitting here, okay? These colored pieces of paper. This clock. All right? There's some chalk here. Eraser. A blindfold. So I'll ask you to deal with different things, all right? And usually the first person that reaches for when I pull up the money is usually this lady. So take those $2.50, look at them, hold them up to the light, make sure that there are no hidden trap doors, no staircases, elevators, mirrors, television monitors. That they are, what I say, solid $0.50. Right? Would you hand them over here to Steve? Steve, here's an adamant. I'm going to ask you to start handing me these. They're very sticky. Would you hand me the tape, starting with this one, working all the way down to the long one here? Now, what's going to happen? I'm going to try to dry my face so I can get these tapes to stick. I'm going to remove my sense of sight and be down in front. Be careful. Well, last time I fell off the stage, I broke about 9 ribs in one to one man. So I'll try not to fall off the edge with the blindfold on. May I have one coin? Oops, one coin. Okay? And could you hold that for me? It's not too damp yet. May I have one piece of tape? You get the next one ready. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to take this $0.50. In a moment, I'm going to embed it in the socket of my eye. But what I want to do is first kind of block this down. As soon as you have your tape, you can go for the next one. Okay? Coin number one and tape number one. Here we go. Okay? Now I have the next coin, please. Tape number two, coin number two. Here we go. Left that in the room. Number three. Tape number three? Good. Number four? Number five? Okay. Number six? Just a second, we'll just slowly finish it up. Number seven? And now number eight. Is that to send over? Can you straighten out a bit? Okay. Now somebody said over here on the side, I can see out of my nose, something black or mask. Good. Would you now take the mask that's there beside the blackboard? Sir, would you press the coins to make sure they're in the sockets of my eyes? Are they there? Good. May I have the blindfold, please? Hold it up to the light first. Make sure that there's no way that you can see through it. And may I have the mask then? Now, ladies and gentlemen, hold it just a second. I have put $2.50 in the sockets of my eyes. I've covered that then with eight pieces of 2 weeks surgical adhesive tape. I've covered that now with a pair of masks, making it impossible to see, and I'm going to try now to use my physical senses. Could you, dear, put the young lady, put the microphone stand on the other side of the stage for a moment? Sir, would you reach, whatever, young lady, would you get back? Would you now take the colored pieces of paper, construction paper, off the clip, show them to the audience, and then mix them up so that they're in no particular order? Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is possible to, and it's being taught now in many schools, to read color by just a vibration. As you well know, color is a different vibration or frequency of light. So So would you please select one paper, show it to the audience, and we'll show you now the first step in super senses. Would you put them in? You got one chosen?
No.
Please place them under my hand. I don't want to touch it, I just want to be near the color.
What?
Okay. All right. No, I mean, this is right. Okay. The first time you had the paper wrong. No batteries for paper, sir. The first time that you put the paper up there, it was the right side up. Now, I'm going to take a guess with you. The second color, a pink?
Yeah.
Was it pink?
Yeah.
Amazing. Thank you. Let's try another. Wow, if I said black on white, that was my mistake. But they were white pearls on a black blouse, if I correct it. Hey, I'm colorblind. What do you say?
No.
Okay. Let's try another one now. Okay. Hold on just a second, sir. This is my act. Thank you. Is the color yellow? It is? Thank you. That's too light. One more. Now hold it down just a second. It's very confusing what's going on, but we'll try one more color. All right. Did you put yellow back up there again? Thank you. All right. Now let's, if you would please, put the colors back on the clip, put them back in the position that you found them on the board. Tell me when you send it back. You're at the post office? Okay. You like special. That's all I got going now. Are you finished, sir?
No.
What I'm going to try now is to use a sense of hearing. This is where you can help me out in the audience. I'm going to ask you to even listen to what's going to happen. Are you there? Okay. Would you lead me over here to the corner of the stage on the right side? I don't want to go off the edge. But just please take me by the arm and lead me out here at the edge. Right to the edge. Okay. Now, each one of you go back, stand beside the blackboard, please. One on each side of the blackboard. I'm going to ask the young lady now, okay? Now, can you people here on the side, the people on the side, please back up if you would, as far back as you can, so the people on stage, back up. Besides, because I want to hold over as many people as I can to see this from the stage. All right, now, ma'am, would you take the chalk? And what I want you to do is to write when I say go. I want you to write in large numbers so that everybody in the room can see a complicated number. It could be a 4, 5, or 6-digit number. I'll tell you when to start. Ladies and gentlemen, now we're going to try an experiment in X-ray vision. You listen to the sound of the chalk as it scrapes on the board. I'll tell you when to start. Go. Okay, have you finished? The first number is, it's kind of curly. Is it a 2?
Yeah.
Is it followed by a 4?
Wow.
So let me play a stage answer. Was there a 2 and a 4? Is that followed by a 6, a 3, and a 9?
Yeah.
And then the third number is the third. Now, gentlemen, and sir, please. The gentleman, sir, would you listen to what I have to say? I want you to write a word on the blackboard, nice and large, please. Write a word on the blackboard if you would, please. Any word that you want to write. I'll tell you when to start. Keep it clean. Keep it clean. You ready? So, listen to the sound. And I think that the gentleman that made that sound probably is a cow. Say more now. All right. So raise the boy. I'd like the lady now to help me with me. I want you to listen to what I have to say. I want you to make a complicated line around the blackboard. Make make it continuous any configuration you want, but make it continuous the lines that cross itself. But I want a complicated line. You understand? Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, watch her as she does this, and she does it carefully. So. Okay, now, please. Thank you. Are you finished here? Fantastic. Would you take me and lead me to the board? Take my hand, please, to my arm. Lead me to the blackboard. Now, you drew a complicated line on the board. Can I have a shot, please? Thank you. Now, I'm going to give you the microphone in a moment. I'm going to ask you to put the shot at the beginning of the line that you drew. I'm going to try, in essence, to... I don't know how, what's going to happen because several people on the front were making comments. I was distracted from what was happening. But I'm going to try, if I can, to use what we call it great vision to duplicate what she did. Take the mic. Okay, we'll do it only to count of three. Okay, are you ready here? You ready? Okay. I realize I'm taking a chance to be around me. All right. All right. Tell me when you're finished. The audience ready to go? Okay. Count of three. In your mind's eye, do not call it out. Keep it to yourself, but picture in your mind's eye. One, two, okay. So I got something that says two numbers. One was something after 10 and one was quarter after 12 or something like that. One hand's on the 12, one's on the other side. Am I correct? That's what I got? Is that what you have? Thank you very much. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Because I received some other patterns with it, something with a 10 in it. I don't know why, but I went with like that 12-15. I want to go back to center stage, and would you bring the microphone stand in front of me, please? Just leading to center stage. And you can put the microphone stand there. Well, now, each one of you, if you would please, one stand on each side of me. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to take off this blindfold and then go in natural moves. The two of you watch carefully to make sure that no pins have been broken or pried away. Before I do this, you hold that part. I'm going to take, first of all, the mask off. Okay? And I want you to watch now. I want you to watch and make sure that the half dollars are still there in the sockets of my eyes. Are they there? Okay?
Give it away.
My day for the night. All right, here we go. All right, don't mind. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. You've been a wonderful audience. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Now, I want you to know that what I I've done this evening is not supernatural. Any one of you can do what I've done here on stage with about 35 years of practice. Now, I'd like to do this. Let me roll this back to the corner, because in just a moment, we're going to bring out on stage the gentleman who started the show, Stephen Clary. I want you to know that I've enjoyed performing for you. You've been a delightful audience. I hope you've enjoyed what you've seen. Remember that the only limitations you have are the limitations that you place on yourself as you go forward in life.
Ladies and gentlemen, Earl Stapper!
Thank you. Good night.
Caroline, come on up here, Caroline. You can Did you do that?
No, I didn't.
Okay.
See the top card? I want you to take this card. Look at it. Show it to yourself. Show it to people behind you. Show it to the audience. But don't tell me. Okay. Now I want you to place, if anyone's back in the past, place it right up in here. Now you push it all the way in. As I say, take the path you just really should. I want you to hold on to that. I just don't know if the sense of bringing you this routine. Because I'm cheap. Now I want you to place them in a paper bag. Go ahead and place them down in there. Go ahead. You can put them down, drop them down in there. Go ahead, let go. She drawn some. And she sort of let them fall out of her fingers. Well, lots of grace there for you to begin to do some other. Okay, now I'm going to give it to the bag a nice good shake. Have a seat. Have a seat. Now let's give her a round of applause. Thank you very much. I don't know if set this down. This was very reason for a long time in the Vegas. If you saw what I was doing, you would probably kill me. We're going to do a trick that you can't do right now. We'll come back to that in just a moment. Now, I'm just trying to get a knot on the end of the roof right there. I want you to try and help me. Here we go. Ready? One, two, three. Everybody think of the knot down there, and we'll see if we can get it on there. Here we go. One, two, three. Huh? Did you like that? Let me show you how I do this. I start off, I place the knot in my hand the entire time. I drop this end of the rope. When you want to get the knot there, you just drop it in with a knot. And that's how you get the knot. And that's a trick that you can do. Now, I'm going to start something that's a little bit more difficult. I'm going to try to get a card in the bag, knotted around the rope. This time I have no knot. I'm going to try to get a card in the bag. Do you think it would be just such a right to do that? I'm scared of the heck out of it. No. I'm just trying to wake you up over there for a big part. It's coming up. Good. We got a card. That's the one card. The drink from your card. Is that the card? Can you get it? That's scary. That's why I'm mad. Drop that down the bag. Now, I took to the desk just before coming out here, and I said I wanted to demonstrate something that you use for cooking your food tonight. So here it is, guys. Here it is. This is the handiest, handiest kitchen utensil. To come along since the miracle works out. It's chop-o-matic. That's right, chop-o-matic. It's going to turn those tedious hours in the kitchen into just a few moments of cooking for pleasure. Ladies and gentlemen, you have to get this for the little lady in your life. Now, you can rest assured it'll last a lifetime because it's made of you, right? That's the same material that your telephone is made out of. And it's called a handy accessory. Look, you ask yourself, how does it work? The bear is up to this place to do the chop-o-matic, grab the handle, it practically works all by itself. That's just a few of the uses of dices, slices, makes julienne and fries, and everything else the way it's down there like this. Somebody else in the front row of the handle? Come on, you're not laughing. Come up here and help me. Now, I was glad you were serious. You were thinking, oh my, the reason we use that as efficiently as you just did? Come on up here. Stand up, somebody can go see you. Let's go see you around the bar. Okay, we'll lift the handle up, place the vegetable in there, grab the handle, and see how easy that works. Now, you don't have to worry about cutting yourself, can you? Because the blade is fleshly hardened. Let me show you what happens when my hand goes into here. Oh, maybe my hand's too big. You can help me out by putting your hand in there. That's the one. Everybody, no time as the
break them down, they'll still cut the vegetables, but it will not hurt any pretty skin.
Wow, that lunch is a head trip.
Okay, here we go. I'm going to take one vegetable right up here at the top. Can you grab another vegetable? Can you put it in front of a thing there? Yeah. Oh, vegetable. Put one in. Hold it right there. That's good. Just like that. We'll cut the vegetable. Just like that. Can you feel that, Cindy? That's okay. Sometimes they do that when they're new. Put it in the bottom hole. Hold it down there. Just like that. Okay. Here we go. On the count of three. Hold that, Cindy. You got that? You hold that? Okay. Here we go. Okay. It's not the vegetable, but your hand remained, and it looks like it's a technique. So if you lost your hand, that's okay, the vegetable will be a nice big one. That's what you got. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We're going to go back to some music now. Christine is a lovely and talented Dana. She's a model. I'm very happy to have her working with me tonight. She thinks about doing this for a living. We just talked about it. Okay. This is an illusion that's popularized around the LA area. I call it the Death Bath Illusion. I hope you enjoyed it. Dana, come on up here, please, if you want. Thank you.
me come down here. How you doing down here? You having a good time this evening? Well, I want to tell you, we've enjoyed ourselves very much. We're very happy. We're very proud that you asked us to share this evening with you. I just want to say that we've enjoyed it. We wish you the best of luck. And remember this, young ladies and gentlemen, no matter where you go in life, there you are. Thank you. Good night. Thank you very much. Please don't look into mine.
I want to design aircraft for the United States Air Force. If you could be anybody in the world, who would you most like to be like? I'd have to say Tom Cruise, because he's a top guy. He's number one.
Come on,
aircraft you're going.
If you could be anybody in the world, who would you like to be like?
Myself, I don't know. I don't like to be like other people.
Good. Be when you grow up.
I want to be an architect.
If you could be anybody in the world, who would you want to be?
Hugh Hefner.
Did you say Hugh Hefner? If you could be anybody in the world, who would you like to be like?
Myself.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
Architect.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
Yeah.
As long as it stays in motion.
Yeah.
Say hi to the camera. Hi, Mr. Cameraman.
How's it going, man?
One of these two people.
Yeah! Riverside!
10 years?
I don't know. Probably finishing college or getting my degree.
In what?
Accounting.
In accounting.
Uh-huh. Maybe I'll be a CPA.
Maybe? With any luck at all. Think about what I'm going to be doing in 10 years.
You think you'll know?
Well, hopefully I'm going to get a Mount Zach for a degree in fire science, become a fireman, and get married to her.
So we know what you'll be doing in 10 years.
I'm going to have my own restaurant, and I'll be married.
Ooh.
I will be married.
That's better.
Yeah. 10 years, sir.
It'll be the best.
I'll be making more money out of anyone on this whole boat.
Doing what?
I'll be installing all the radars for all the F-16 fighter planes for the U.S.
Well, here's number one. I don't know what else.
It doesn't work.
Everyone?
Yeah. back.
Bye.
Bye. Come back to my man.
Bye.
We can have this down there for you.
I'm sorry.
Always wanted to say that.
The caveman. The caveman. Himself. The caveman.
Things that we were working on.
blue chain, it pulls us apart. When the light gets in your heart, baby, don't you forget about me. Forget about me.